So here's the answer. I filled in all the missing values for you. And let's try to check a few. For example, let's take the elements related to x1. We moved from x0 to x1, which added one of the main diagonal. We moved from x1 to x2, which added another one, so we have two. But we also had one observation in x1. We incremented by 2 because of the measurement strength, 0.5. 1 over that is 2, so when we added the measurement, we ended up with 4. Let's pick this off-diagonal element over here. This was only affected when moving from x1 to x2, and it was a minus 1. This element over here was affected when we sensed L1 from x1. And again, the off-diagonal element is negative. So we added a minus 2 over here. It's quite involved, as you can see. Let's take a number on the right side, the minus 2 over here. This is adding up every contribution to x2. The first one occurred when we moved into x2 from x1, at which point we added 2. When x2, we also measured landmark L1 with a measurement value of 2. We have to multiply it up by 2 to arrive at 4 and subtract it. So we add minus 4, we get the minus 2. If you work out all these examples using the math we explained in class and working in the fact that measurements get a default factor of 2 for every value you add, you'll arrive at exactly this matrix over here. I hope you got a good number of numbers right. That was not an easy task.